Hello students, good morning. We started the adventure of Toto in my previous video, where I explain you that Toto is a baby monkey and how grandfather bought Toto and he kept it secret from the grandmother. Now Toto freed himself. Grandfather thought him very clever. Here the story goes on that Toto in cage with other pets in servants' quarter, and grandfather took Toto to Saharanpur. So here the story is completed. Now from here we start with that grandmother gave Toto a bath in a winter season. She gave him a warm bath during cold winter evenings. Toto had seen the writer take his bath. Writer means Ruskin Bond, who is the writer of that story, or the grandson of grandfather. Now like him, Toto too checked the temperature of the water, then got into the bowl, first with one foot then the other. He sat comfortably in the bowl. He rubbed himself all over with soap, and when the water became cold he got out of it and ran to the kitchen fire to dry himself. Here now one day Toto had almost boiled himself alive. A big kettle was left on the fire. Toto removed the lid and found the water warm enough for a bath. He got into the kettle. For a while he enjoyed himself, but when the water grew hotter, he raised himself to get out, but it was cold outside, so he decided to sit down again. He continued hopping up and down from some time. Now grandmother came to his rescue and pulled him half boiled out of the kettle. Now one day a large plate of pulao was standing on the dining table. Toto got into the room and began stuffing himself with the delicious pulao. When grandmother came in, she shouted at him. He threw a plate at her. One of the writer's aunts rushed it forward. Toto hurled a glass of water at her. Now when grandfather arrived, Toto carried the plate up into the branches of a tree. He ate every grain of rice and threw down the empty plate, which broke into 100 pieces. Now this pleased Toto. He chattered with delight. Now the one bad habit of Toto was that whenever he got a chance, he grabbed a lady's dress and tore a hole in it. Grandfather found Toto's mischiefs too expensive, and he sold it back to the tanga driver for only 3 rupees. He bought Toto from 5 rupees, but he sold it only for 3 rupees because he was very mischievous in his behavior. So students, here we complete our lesson. Now let we start our question answer. How does Toto come to grandfather's private zoo? Now grandfather was fond of pet animal and had a private zoo of his own. He had seen Toto, a pretty baby monkey with a tanga driver who used to keep it tied to a feeding trough. The monkey looked so out of place there that grandfather decided to make him a part of his private zoo. Thus Toto came to grandfather's private zoo. Now Toto was a pretty monkey. In what sense is Toto pretty? Toto had bright, sparkling, mischievous eyes, deep-set eyebrows, and white, pearly teeth. His dry, pickled hand had quick, wicked fingers and a tail, which not only added to his beauty, but also worked as his third hand. His mischievous nature added charm to his looks, according to the grandfather. Why does grandfather take Toto to Saharanpur, and why does the ticket collector insist on calling Toto a dog? Now, Toto was kept in a big cage in the servant's quarter. Toto, which was grandfather's private zoo. A number of other pet animals lived there in peace. Toto did not let them sleep at night. Grandfather had to go to Saharanpur the next day to collect his pension. Since Toto could not live with other animals in the servant's quarter, so grandfather decided to take him along with him. Now Toto was put in his big black canvas kit bag with some straw at the bottom. When the bag was closed, Toto could not escape. He stayed in the bag till Saharanpur. When grandfather was giving his ticket to the ticket collector, Toto suddenly thrust his head out of the bag and gave the ticket collector a wide grin. The ticket collector was taken aback but soon regained his poise, but he was annoyed and classified Toto as a dog. Grandfather had to pay fare for Toto's journey too. Here, how does Toto take a bath? Where has he learned to do this? How does Toto almost boil himself alive? Now, during winter evenings, grandmother gave Toto warm water for his bath. At first, Toto would check with his hand if the water was hot enough. When he found its temperature right, he would put one foot first and then the other foot until he was in water up to his neck. Now, he had seen the writer taking bath and learned from him. Then he would hold soap in his hand or feet and rubbed it all over his body. When the water became cold, he came out and ran to the fire in the kitchen to dry himself. Now, in one day, a large kettle was on fire to boil water for tea and Toto's bath. Toto removed the lid, touched water and found it warm enough for a bath. He got into the kettle, sticking his head out. For a while, it was all right, but as water started boiling, he became uncomfortable and started hopping, but did not come out as it was cold outside. Now, luckily, grandmother came there and rescued him for being boiled alive. Next, why does the author say Toto was not the sort of pet we could keep for long? Now, because Toto was not only mischievous, but also mischiefs were very expensive for the family. He tore the expensive wallpapers, dresses, broke plates, etc. Grandfather realized that they could not afford such frequent losses. In fact, he was a wild monkey, not fit to be a pet. So grandfather gave the above statement. So students, your homework is to read the lesson and write the answer in your fair notebook and learn it. Thank you.